When it comes to monsters, it's hard not to think of Godzilla, Bigfoot, or the Loch Ness Monster, but here's a list of some of the creepiest that we've been presented with through some of our favorite movies, stories, and possibly even experiences. We are your hosts, Aaron
and Andrew, and these are your top 10 scary horror movie monsters.
Starting off the list at number 10, we have Sinister's Bugal. Bugal is an obscure pagan deity that feeds on children, serving as their main antagonist of the movie Sinister. He would manipulate the lives of children, have them kill their families, and then consume the child's soul. Starting from 1966, Bugal would manipulate the minds of children into killing their families, filming the murders on a Super 8 film reel, and each film would consist of innocent looking clips taken of the family, then the murders would be filmed. In the extended ending section, the child would come closer to the camera before making a scary gesture. Bugal would make a very subtle appearance in each of the films. The first one is The Pool Party in 1966. In this whole movie, a family is seen playing in a swimming pool. Then the film cuts to the pool at night with each member of the family strapped to pool chairs. The filmmaker then pulls a rope, pulling each of the pool chairs into the swimming pool, leaving the family to drown to death.
At a number 9 spot, we have Pennywise the Dancing Clown. Pennywise is truly one of the most iconic villains in horror movie history. Introduced in Stephen King's It, Pennywise is a shape-shifting creature who is billions of years old. But don't let his old age fool you, because he terrorized the children in town of Derry every 27 years to feed off their souls. But since we both have the 1990 version and the 2017 version of Pennywise, I think it's best to look at both of them and why they work. In my opinion, the 90s version of Pennywise, played by the great Tim Curry, seems more creepy with a hint of serial killer vibes. This version actually looks like he is enjoying himself a bit too much. The 2017 version of Pennywise, played by Bill Skarsgård, has a more monster and demonic feel to it. You can feel the lust it has to feed on children. It gets pretty scary at times when this Pennywise lurks in the shadows like a predator, waiting for the right moment to strike. Both Pennywise are amazing in their own movies, but I really just couldn't put one above the other. They're just too good.
Cloverfield, 1808. It might ring a bell, but these monsters were definitely scary. In the movie, the monster came from the Atlantic Ocean, where it was awakened by a submarine sent down from a Japanese station. The monster rampages through Manhattan, destroying the city in its path. This destruction causes the United States government to sacrifice New York City in an attempt to kill the monster, with heavy ordinances in the Hammerdown Protocol. The monster is about 300 feet, and it has a huge fin tail. The utmost double-jointed limb pair is longer than the other two, ending with a multi-fingered hand which can bend backwards so that the creature can walk on its fingers. The double-jointed squat legs are powerful enough to support the creature's mass, and yet still allow it to move quickly through the city. Each of its feet is about 40 feet in length, roughly the size of the city's transit bus.
At a number 7 spot, we have the lipstick-faced demon from Insidious. Insidious was a fresh horror movie in a time where horror movies became repetitive and predictable. Its use of sound was surprising to many. I don't know about you, but the intro that shows the word Insidious in all red with the loud music actually scared me so much. Now on to the lipstick demon, otherwise known as the man with fire in his face. He is the main villain of Insidious. He is played by American composer and actor Joshua Bishara. This demon is a monstrous and sinister creature, tall and gaunt, with a dark humanoid figure. Most of his body is black as coal, with long spider-like fingernails, hooves, and a long forked tail. His head is mostly bald, except for long tufts of hair around his ears. Although he does not wear any sort of clothing, he often wears silvery metallic claws over his own fingers. Yep, pretty creepy.
At number 6, we have The Thing. The Thing is an extremely hostile, shape-shifting extraterrestrial organism and the primary antagonist of the 1982 science fiction film The Thing. The Thing has the ability to assimilate other life forms in order to survive and spread. The original physical characteristics of The Thing and its motivations are unknown, as it could have assimilated hundreds, if not thousands, of other species before it crashed on Earth. Unlike most creatures, The Thing possesses no inherent standard autonomy. The Thing has the ability to reconstitute itself following immense damages, and it's invulnerable to most conventional forms of attack. However, it is vulnerable to the fire and potentially molecular acid, since they both destroy the creature at its cellular level.
Right in the humbar list, we have the crawlers from Descent.
Please, is there anybody there? Hello?
This race of cave-dwelling humanoids, located in a cave in North Carolina, have adapted to complete darkness, and it's said that they lost any previous traces of humanity they may have once had. which turned them into these monsters. These monsters are what makes this movie so horrifying. Their unpredictable nature, along with their bloodlust, makes them a reasonable candidate on this list. The movie has a group of female explorers that decide to go on a cave exploration only to be met with these scary guys. This movie gets bloody and pretty gory, so don't act like I didn't warn you. Their abilities include climbing on walls, superhuman speed, strength, and echolocation since they are blind creatures.
At number four, we have Prometheus. The Hammerpede is the nickname given to the cobra-like creatures seen in Prometheus. Though not technically a new creature, the Hammerpedes were once a result of worms being dragged into the dark liquid. I don't think these were indigenous worms either. It was a result of David dragging them into the chamber under his feet from the Prometheus ship. The dark liquid mutated the worms to create these aggressive snake-like creatures. In the film, Fifield and Milburn get lost in the temple after the others have returned to the Prometheus ship.
At number three spot, we have Valak the Nun. Portrayed by Bonnie Ahrens, Valak is a powerful demon that manifests as a demonic nun to both mock the faith of its enemies and to hide among them. It also holds the title as the arch enemy of the Warrens. Lorraine Warren in particular, with the rivalry starting when she exorcised it from Maurice towards the end of its original film. Valak is a very wicked, ruthless, sadistic, cold, and completely despicable demon. She's a complete menace and is very scary. Almost forgot to mention, I mean, look at this. That scene shook me in the theaters, I won't lie. Apart from the film, Valak exists in past mythology. Valak is known as the great president of hell with over 30 legions of demons at his command. Valak manifests as an angelically winged boy riding a two-headed dragon, and it possesses the power to find treasures. In the case of the film, Valak's treasure was a vision of Ed Warren being impaled, which it offered to his wife Lorraine as a gift.
Here at number two, we have the Babadook. The Babadook is summoned when a 6-year-old Samuel Vanek discovers a mysterious book in the shelf titled The Babadook, also known as the Babadook book. After pleading with his mother Amelia to read it to him, she finally gives in and they open it up. It's seemingly a children's pop-up book, but with each page being more disturbing than the last, Samuel gets so frightened and ultimately awakens the dark being within the story. The Babadook, like the boogeyman, seems to feed off fear. It might be said that, in the context of the film, the Babadook is the boogeyman for Samuel and his mother. The being gets stronger the more you think of it, eventually to the point where it can manifest into something physical. It is possible to be possessed by the Babadook, as Amelia does in the second half of the film. When in this state, she becomes hostile, aggressive, succeeding in killing the family dog and attempt to kill her own son.
Taking our number one spot, we have Samara from The Ring. This movie made many of us keeping a light on at night, and for me, it made me scared of a TV showing static because that's how Samara attacks. Initially, Samara appears as a pretty and young girl with brown eyes. In addition to these features, she has long brown hair and fair skin, and she wore a white nightgown. Except when she's out here tormenting and hunting people, otherwise known as her cursed form, Samara's hair is now dark, soaking wet, which hides her waterlogged and deformed face when she got pushed down a well and left to pass away there. To get her into the cursed form, it's said that you need to watch a cursed film of hers in which you will get a call with a raspy voice saying 7 days. She is noteworthy among other horror villains for she wields no distinctive weapon, only kills her victims off screen, and her killing methods are purely psychological in nature rather than physical, and remains completely enshrouded with mystery and speculation. She's still creepy to me till this day, and if I ever see static on my TV, I will always think of her. Well, there we have it, our top 10 scary horror movie monsters. What'd you guys think about this list? Leave a comment down below. Because I'm your host, Andrew.
I'm Aaron. And you know what? You only have 7 days.